Well, hello everyone. Here we are for the Neben event. The race at Ventoux. Sometimes I forget to turn that speaker off. Alright. Looks like we've got a good crowd here. You see I'm sporting the official RGT kit as modelled by my avatar as well. I'm afraid as I'm racing today my camera skills won't be quite as good as recent amber events. In fact, I will probably put it on normal mode to start off with until I get to a point where I can think about using my options. We've definitely got a good crowd here. No bots, it's all human. Well, 45 seconds. Those that see me ride these 1-2 races, I don't go too fast at the start. So, everybody move on. 7 seconds, it always comes around so fast, doesn't it? Okay, here we go. And there goes everybody else. Right, Tim. Thank you. Looks like I'm getting no mates. Draft here, just for acts of it. Just before the climb. Here we go. I'd say it's quite weird. Look at my avatar and me wearing the same kit for the first time. Ooh. But Matteo's broken me. Stepped it up a patch. And I'm not going to pull it. Thank you. welcome respite for a few seconds. I try really hard not to look at those kilometers and went. I don't want to see them till it's less than 10. Otherwise they can play on your mind. What is mine? Looks like TL is catching me up. So Canberra's moved up to fourth. Yeah, see ya. Thank you. Looks like Hervé's pulling me in as well. Today this is a race of attrition and I'm dying. There it is, pulling me back pretty quick. Looks like I'm pulling this group in. Hervé's pulling me in. Might have a group of five soon. Might think that'll work well for drafting, but at this speed uphill, there's practically zero drafting effect, as you'd expect. Hervé's on top of me. Right. Whilst there's virtually no drafting effect at this speed, psychologically it can help, just following the wheel. So I might stick in here. Yeah. So much for sticking in. Purposely not looking at these KM banners. Oh. Looks like I'm pulling away on these guys. But you never expect that to last. Oh. Unless I'm wrong, Darren looks stronger on the flat. So I'm just going to tuck in on his flat and get a little bit of a breather. Hopefully, if I can stay with him. You're wondering why I've got a draft now, because we're only at 1%. Yeah. And was up to third. Was hoping to move the cameras around, but sorry, I'm kind of focused on my race at the moment. Okay. Oh. Hey. Whew. Welcome, sir. Thank you. Last K. That's such a nice start. Glad I didn't have to sprint. Wow. Nice work, Dan. I was very glad I moved away from you the last 3K. Didn't want to sprint. Finish. Oh, boy, that's hard. It's Sorry everyone, I was planning on moving the camera up and down the grid order or position order and seeing how everyone was going, but being selfish, my race was a little bit close, and I've done that before where in a close race I've moved the camera around and completely lost a place or a couple of places due to not seeing I was dropping, being dropped, or somebody coming catching me up. So I had to keep the camera on there, I'm afraid. But it was a good race. 1:13:52 for me. That's pretty much a good time for me. It looks like the time for the climb was 1:09:20 odd, which again, got to be happy with. So let's go through the order so far. Hacken. I have to admit, I didn't see, at least I don't remember seeing him on the list for the front group, but maybe I was just blind. But anyway, Hacken, 1:02:03. Yeah. No idea how to say it, sorry. Excuse my pronunciations of everybody. 1:02:07, so that must have been a tight sprint between you two guys. Sorry, I say guys. Could be anyone, so between you two. Amber coming third, 1:03:17. Amber's got to be happy with that. I think possibly Yaya wins the overall, I think. I could be wrong. Keith, 1:04:13 from fourth. Andrew, rounding out the top five, in 1:05:22. Glenn, 1:09:31, so reasonable gap between fifth and sixth, 4 minutes on. And Tim Cusack, seventh, 1:09:33, so that must have been a close sprint for sixth there, and it looks like Glenn obviously took it on the line. Eighth, Hervé, 1:11:18. Ninth, Matteo, 1:11:53. 10th, Evan, 1:12:16. Javier, 1:13:29 in 11th. Oh, excuse me. Oh, sorry. Darren, 13th. 1:14:17, real long battle with you, Darren. I was very glad when I started to pull away from you. I did at one point, and then you came back on that flatter section, and I thought it could be in trouble, but I managed to just pull you back again, and then eventually drop you. Oh boy. So, CL 1:15:13 in 14th. Running out the top 15 is 1:16:07. 16th Giovanni, 1:16:30. So, fairly close call there between Warren and Giovanni. Jim, the 17th, 1:17:12. And Joris, 1:19:36 and 18th. Let's see how many more we get in while I'm warming down. Oh man. Well, if anybody's wondering about the team kit and how it is for keeping you cool, well, I managed to keep it on throughout the whole race, so it's quite good at wicking the sweat. Although I have got three fans on me. How come, no matter how many fans you've got, there's never enough though? Well, I have to say, I recently bought a remote control 20 inch fan, and I have to say, the best thing I've ever bought, the most useful thing I've bought for a while. I never realised just how important having a remote control fan is. It's just wonderful. And I would strongly suggest, if you're going to buy a new fan, get a remote control one. What I got is a Black & Decker 20 inch one from Amazon UK. I think it's £50, £49 or something. But I have to say, looks pretty well built and very, very useful having a remote control, as I say. Oh. One, two is never an easy climb or race, but you may have noticed I am very much a keep a steady pace all the way, as opposed to ebbing and flowing. Even though I can usually hold around 240 watts this for an hour, which for me is 62k, so around about 3.9, something like that. So that's why at the start of the race I don't go mad, and get to the climb and then just try and keep a reasonable pace around the 4 watts per kilo. Obviously some places it drops, others are a little bit higher, but I try and ride roughly around 4 the whole climb. That way I usually find I can, come on, well, I'm not going to come on stronger, but if anybody's waning towards the top, I just managed to grab them or pull away from somebody who's waning. I'm not one of these climbers that can put in a quick 5 plus section and then drop it back down again and keep doing that. Doesn't work for me. I need to be constant. That's why I find that onto it's a very, I find, mentally difficult race. More mental than physical for me. But I have to say, it's a lot easier when you've got bigger fields and more riders around you. Like today was a good group. Pretty much throughout the climb I was riding other people, which just, as I said, there's not much of a drafting benefit apart from on a few of the flatter sections, but on the whole there's hardly anything to be gained from drafting, so it's more a psychological thing to follow someone's will or just keep them at bay. But as I said, I do prefer to ride at a fairly good constant, so I do have a tendency to let people go if they're going to push me, and sometimes I manage to pull them back a bit later on. Right, let's see how we're going, because I'm sure there's quite a few more people come in. So where was I? Up to about 18. Joris, put your glasses back on. So Joris, 18th, 1:19:36. Sammy, is that Sammy that does the Magic Roads, all the top 100 climbs? Could be. Where am I? There. That's 1:20:57 in 19th place. Strong ride, mate. In 20th, right, so rounding out the top 20. Patrick, 1:22:83. Oh. 21st, Greg, 1:22:16. So pretty close to Patrick there. And Kevin, 20 seconds, 1:22:43. Addy, oh, come on. Where are you, Addy? There, 23rd. Addy, 1:23:29. 24th, Lorenzo, 1:24:36. 25th, Bullet John, interesting name, 1:24:57. 26, Jamie, 1:25:31. 27, Fran, 1:26:24. 28th, Chad, 1:26:49. 29th, Stu, 1:27:38. See who comes in 30th and rounds off the top 30. So I'm just waffling here, I'm just warming down and talking rubbish. I've yet to climb this rail. I was planning to do it this year, but clearly the lockdown may well scupper that. We've got a 2 week summer holiday booked in Austria in August, which we go regularly in the summer. I know most people generally go to Austria in the winter for skiing, but we like to go there in the summer. Stunning during the summer. We go to Meyerhofen, and I always hire a bike out there and get a couple of weeks riding the mountains in the morning while my family are relaxing by the pool. It works really well. for us, me. And I have to say, cycling in Austria is simply stunning. Vastly underrated place to cycle in. Anyway, that's booked for August, but we're not entirely sure whether that's going to go ahead or not. I was planning on going to Ventoux about 4 weeks after I get back from that, so around about early September. But again, not sure whether that's going to be a goer or not. Oh, this is nice to warm down here. Alright, turn the fan down. Just love that remote control. Alright, so where were we? I think we were up to 29, weren't we? So, Dave, rounding out the top 30, 128.52. 31st, Jan, 129.01. I'm trying to do all the all the courses, all the climbs in RGT for real. I done the Yorker and love it over there, and Cap was just stunning in real life. Was pretty much why we changed the start point in Cap. The original start point for Cap was on the dual carriageway outside of Portopienka. But after I did it in real life, I said it'd be wonderful to start it at the other side of the town, right on the beach and right along the promenade, and see the view of the mountains, and it was decided that was the best way to go, and it came out really well. Anyway, again, I'm waffling. Right, where are we? So, Evan's just come in, 131.32. So again, apologies to Amber and Tim for not getting this stream looking at anybody else but myself. I'm afraid competition was a bit too tight around me to move the camera around. Anyway, I think I've warmed down, so I'm going to call it a day. That was a really good race, everyone. So I can grab some screen prints of the finishing order, put them on the site. Right, there we go. Okay, I'm done. Right, thanks for watching, everyone. Let's shut this up. Let's go to the next one. Cheers.